What do you do when your quick release couplings leak? Hello everyone, my name is Jim. And in this video, I'll tell you everything you need to know about quick release couplings, what to do when they leak, and whether to repair or replace them. Quick release couplings are also known as quick disconnect fittings or quick connects. They're used to connect two applications. 99% of the time, they link a flexible part, a hose, to a fixed part. And they provide a fast and easy way to connect or disconnect piping and tubing with a special design that's supposed to prevent any leaks. We see them in a wide variety of industries, including, of course, agriculture. For example, when you connect some type of machinery to your tractor, the valve that closes the system is a quick release coupling. They're designed to make it easy for you to attach, detach multiple hydraulic systems to your tractor and to switch between equipment without leaking any hydraulic fluid in the process. What type of equipment with quick release couplings brought you to this video? Something to hook to your tractor or something else entirely? Let me know in the comments below. Quick release couplings consist of a male and a female part. Inside the latter, you can find an O-ring, which is meant as a seal to prevent any leaks. When a male and female parts are not connected, they're shut off, so no liquid should be spilling out, even when they're under pressure. Once they're put together, the valves open and your hydraulic system is complete. But what do you do when there's a leak? See how there's a tiny drop of oil on the connector? That's not a good sign. Like I said before, couplings are designed to be anti-leak. When a leak does occur, it's usually due to wear and tear or improper installation. It's important to take a good look at your vehicle, especially at the quick release coupling. Ask yourself, what do I see? What do I smell? Where did it go wrong? Let's get into the possible solution of repairing the coupling. So let's move to step number one. Quick release couplings come in many different shapes and sizes. Two of the most common types are the poppet type and the flat face series. You have to make sure that both the male and the female components belong to the same type, as they're not interchangeable. Other important aspects to keep in mind are the coupling's dimensions and thread type. To help you find the right part, each manufacturer etches the part number into the component. Sometimes the number isn't visible anymore, in which case you'll need to do a little bit more homework and maybe try different options. Another thing you can do to find out the right size is to measure the outer ring of the male part. If you have one at home, you can use a caliper to do this. Kramp has developed an easy-to-use chart to help you find the right size and style of coupling. Just click here to learn more. All right, now that you know the right type and size of coupling we're looking at, it's time to move on to step number two. When it comes to leaks, the problem is usually the O-ring. That's the component in the female part that's designed to keep the fluid in the space between the two parts. It can get damaged around the edges over time and will need to be replaced every so often, depending on how much you use the coupling and what it's used for. This brings me to one of the methods to solve a leak in your quick release coupling. First, check the male part for dents and scratches to see if it's damaged and needs to be replaced. If it looks fine, then the male part is most likely not causing the problem. You might need a new O-ring and a backup ring and a dental pick, which you can find in the seal kit. Make sure it doesn't have a pointy end though, as you don't want to damage anything. Next, simply remove the O-ring and the backup ring and replace them with new ones, squeezing them in until they're sitting nice and tight within the coupling. The alternative to repairing the coupling is to replace the complete quick release coupling. Let's take a look. There are a couple of reasons why replacing the complete quick release coupling is more advantageous than just replacing the O-ring and the backup ring. If, for example, your coupling is old and worn from years of service, replacing the complete coupling might be the way to go. In the end, it'll be more economical and you'll have brand new material you can rely on. You can use the information you gathered in step one to find the right male and female part. Stay tuned because after this, I have some important information for you. Remember, it's important to find the right match for your machinery. And if you do decide to replace the coupling, here are a few things to keep in mind. Safety first. Don't just open up your machinery as the system might still be under pressure. First, you have to make sure that all pressure has left the system. Work in a clean environment to avoid contamination of any kind. And use the right tools. Make sure they're clean and the proper size. And be careful not to damage your couplings or system in the process. Clean up spilled oil when you're done. Finally, here's a bit of advice for the future. First and foremost, make sure your equipment is clean to avoid contamination of any kind, such as dust or dirt. You can use a dust cover, which usually comes with the equipment. Also make sure that you use clean tools every time you connect or disconnect your couplings. And last but not least, handle your equipment with care. This should go without saying, but you'd be surprised to learn how many leaks occur because of improper installment or carelessness. So always treat your equipment with respect. All right, to sum up, I'll list all the steps you can take in case you find out you're dealing with a leaking quick release coupling one more time. All right, there you have it. What to do when quick release couplings leak, and some advice on how to prevent it from happening in the future. We have a lot more videos for you, so make sure you hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date on our new videos on our channel. Thanks for watching, and until next time.